So now we've been hearing terms like upskilling, soft skills, and competency in tech when talking about jobs lately. And for good measure, because these are what many employers are looking for these days. But are our schools preparing the future's labor force for these new demands? Cosmopolitan International Institute of Technology, or CIIT, College of Arts and Technology President Sherwin Oh joins us today to tell us why our schools need to produce industry-ready graduates. Welcome to the program, Sherwin.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. Thanks for having us. Good afternoon also to all your viewers.
It's good to have you here, neighbor. Now, our recent interview, you have an office just right across ABS-CBN. Anyway, in one of our interviews with Job Street Seek, it was an eye-opener on the labor supply and demand market, where the need for industry-ready and relevant workers is seen as a challenge. Now, please give us perhaps a sense of what the reality is now, especially with what companies want vis-a-vis the quality of graduates we produce.
Yeah, so I think during the pandemic, one of the key insights of a lot of organizations was really how the role of tech in terms of the ability to continue their organizations, their operations, was really hampered heavily during the pandemic as with the lockdowns. No? A lot of the tech professionals were really came to fold. They became the core strategy of how organizations would sustain their operations. And I think as we exit the pandemic, there's also suddenly a surge in terms of not just technical skills of our students, but also looking into the soft skills that was also heavily impacted because of the limitations that was brought about by the pandemic. You know, I think students just started to be locked in their own homes. The ability to communicate with one another also got affected. But generally, that's the outlook as we now go back to this new normal.
Okay, now Sherwin, how is CIIT addressing the gaps? Because just today we had a story, the National Economic Development Authority stressing the need now for government to really prioritize labor upskilling and even improve employability. So what role do you play there?
Yeah, so for CIIT, that's always been the core. The vision of our founder and president, Niel Dagondon, was really to create a school where the laser focus is really on preparing students for the industry, particularly in the fields of digital arts and tech. When CIIT was founded in 2008, it was really on the backs of our founder having this experience running a startup game development firm in the Philippines, where to grow the company, he really also needed more highly skilled programmers, developers, and designers. It was a result of that challenge that led to the idea of creating this school that really provides highly specialized skills. Now, through the years, although CIIT has only been about 15 years, pretty young for a college, what we've really focused on would be creating a lot of company partnerships. Currently, CIIT has over 120 company partners, ranging from software development firms, post-production studios, advertising agencies, animation studios. And basically what we do is we try to work with them on two parts. First, we sit down with them so that they could help us design the curriculum. Partnering with the industry is really, really important because they really know what demands are right there on the ground.
Right.
So they help us with building our curriculum. They tell us which software to use, which equipment to use, what the skills of the students needs to be for them to be employed. A second part would be once our students get to their OJT or internship program during their last year with us, they now have the opportunity to choose among CIIT company partners, now our handpicked company partners, so they could see if the skills that we've taught them actually has really prepared them for the demands of the industry.
Okay, Sherwin, tell us, what makes the CIIT education relevant, and perhaps even more importantly, how do you stay relevant given how quick the landscape can change?
Yeah, innovation has really been the key part of our culture. It's a school that, you know, 15 years ago, we were really just very, very small. We occupied just one floor in a building when CIIT started with 21 students. And I think a very, very strong testament to this culture of innovation is when the pandemic hit back in 2020, mm-hmm. see, it only took CAIT to transition to full online classes in 2 weeks, only because we already had all the systems that we needed to actually continue our education. You know, for the students who did not have internet, we already had a strong partnership with Globe. They sent us so many Wi-Fi sticks that we sent to all our students nationwide. All our high-powered PCs, we sent out to all our students. All of these technologies were already in the cloud before even the pandemic happened. Believe it or not, Stanley, one of the things that we heavily invested on is as early as 2017, CAIT started designing our own in-house program that would help school administrators manage and run the school in a very efficient way.
Okay.
It actually uses AI to basically sort out the entire enrollment of the college, therefore making the entire process much more efficient, much faster, and making our education more accessible.
Okay, let's talk about your programs now. What are the most popular ones, and is it easy to enroll?
Well, we also have our own admission standards. The admissions process in CAIT is basically you apply online, it's fully online. You take the admissions exam. The admissions exam is also something you take on your own. It's okay. AI is the one that makes sure that a student is able to take the exam. All the, I would say, cheat-proof measures were already in place in that system. And basically, students, CAIT specializes in three college programs. The first one is digital arts. The second one is computer science, programming, and game development. And the third one, pretty recent, is really entrepreneurship or technopreneurship. The way the school envisioned this was really to bring together under one roof digital artists or front-end people, the software developers or the back-end, and lastly, entrepreneurs who could combine all these elements and find ways to commercialize it. It's sort of like a vision for a Silicon Valley ecosystem within the Philippines.
Okay, this sounds unique. Now, do you have competition? And perhaps if you do, what is the edge of a CAIT education against competition?
Yeah, I think, you know, at the end of the day, it's really all about trying to help all Filipino students. So I think, yes, there are other schools who are also similar in terms of program offerings, but we'd also want to make sure that the education that we provide isn't just very, very good in terms of the ability to make sure that the students are industry ready. Mm-hmm. But a big challenge for us is really finding ways to make sure that this education is very accessible. The challenge has always been, how do you provide students, how do you provide Filipino students with very, very good facilities, bringing them curriculum that's designed by our company partners, high-end equipment, Apple lab laboratories, high-end Windows PCs, 3D render machines, 3D printing services, but making it very accessible. So if there's an edge of the school, we've always focused on this on ways to innovate to make sure that all of these things remain accessible for our students.
Okay, lastly, Sherwin, where is the main campus and satellite campuses as well? And how can one find out more about CAIT?
Yeah, if you anyone who's interested in the school, just go visit our website, cait.edu.ph, or you can just search for us in Google. We actually have two campuses right now. The main college campus is in Camuning, Quezon City, and the satellite senior high school campus for grades 11 and grade 12 is literally just across ABS-CBN along Mother Ignacia.
All right, Sherwin Oh of Cosmopolitan International Institute of Technology. Yours is a challenging mission to prepare our youth for new roles in the future. We wish you the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Stanley. Bye.